trapped with our karmas and destiny and can be out with faith?
I'll tell you another story. There was this young boy, and in search of knowledge, he approached a guru or a sage in a village, and he started living with his family. And as luck would have it, one day, while his guru was away, the guru's wife started having labor pains. So the disciple, the loyal disciple that he was, he stood guard against the door so that no man could enter the house while she was in labor. And then a kind of a divine being, tried to enter the house. And this disciple stopped him. He says, "Who are you? You cannot enter the house. This is my guru's house and his wife is in labor." So this person said, I am Brahma. I have to enter the house because I have to write the fate of the child who is to be born. So reluctantly, the disciple let Brahma go inside, but sought a promise from him that he would tell the fate of the child once he has written it. So a beautiful boy was born to his guru's wife. And as Brahma came out, Brahma told the disciple that this boy will live a life of penury and hard labor. He will have only a bag of rice and a buffalo. The disciple was very sad to hear this, but then this was the karma of the past lives which this boy had to bear in this life, and he could not do much about it. Few years later, as it happened, kind of the whole situation repeated itself. Guru's wife was delivering again, and the guru was away, and again he was standing guard outside the door. And Brahma made his appearance once again to write the fate of this child who is to be born. Again, the disciple sought the same promise from Brahma that when you come out, you must tell me what is going to be the fate of this child. A beautiful baby girl was born, and as Brahma came out, he told the disciple that this girl would become a common prostitute. Now the disciple was heartbroken to hear this, because how could a girl, a daughter of one of the holiest of sages, can become a prostitute? But again, this was going to be the result because of her karma or her destiny. After a few more years of studying and learning under his guru, he decided to leave the house and do his own sadhana in the mountains. After about 20 years, he suddenly remembered his guru and the Brahma's words and decided to go back to his guru's village and meet with his guru and his family and see how they are doing. When he came back to the village, he found out that his guru and his wife are no more. And he was sad to hear that. And sadder to hear from the neighbors that Brahma's words that he said to him about their destiny had come true. The boy was a lowly porter in the village, doing very hard labor and work. And the girl, his guru's daughter, had indeed become a prostitute. So the disciple first goes to the boy and tells the boy, "You have a sack of rice and a buffalo, right?" He says, "Yes, I have a sack of rice and a buffalo." He said, "Today, you sell the rice and sell the buffalo. Feed your family well. And whatever is left, feed the village. Feed the sadhus. Feed all the people around you. and don't worry about tomorrow. I'll take care of it. Believe in me, because if you remember, I am the disciple of your guru, and you must trust me. And the boy was afraid, of course, because the only possession he had bought that was that sack of rice and the buffalo. And if he would sell it and spend it all in one evening, how will he survive the next day? But he also had a certain belief in this disciple who looked saintly and, you know, had a glowing aura around him. And he remembered him from his childhood. So he agreed to do what was advised to him by the disciple. And they had a feast, and, you know, he fed the villagers, he fed the sadhus, he fed the poor, he fed the needy from the money he made from selling the buffalo and his sack of rice. But he slept a little uncomfortably, a little afraid. What is going to happen tomorrow? How am I going to feed myself tomorrow? But when he woke up in the morning, he was amazed to find there was another sack of rice and another buffalo. Because the destiny had intended that he will always have one sack of rice and one buffalo. Right? So now the disciple advised him, now repeat this every day. Every day you sell your sack of rice, sell your buffalo, feed the whole village, feed your family, feed all the sadhus, feed all the poor. Make sure not a single morsel of rice remains and not a single cent of the money remains till the next day. Spend everything the same day. Now he goes to the girl, his guru's daughter. She's of course looking for a way out. She tells the disciple, I'm ashamed of the kind of life I'm leading. So any advice you can give me, I'll be happy to hear it. He told her, for your services, you ask for the finest string of pearls. If only a person who can give you the finest string of pearls can sleep with you for the night. Now, she was a prostitute in a village, which was a poor village, so all her customers, of course, did not have the means to give her the finest set of pearls for her services. Now, what happened? The Brahma himself appeared disguised and offered her a finest set of pearls and spent the night with her. And she went running back next day to the disciple and said, this is what happened. A luminous being came into my house yesterday and offered me this beautiful set of pearls. He said, now spend this set of pearls. Sell this set of pearls, spend all the money you make from this set of pearls, buy yourself clothes, buy yourself the essential things, but make sure no money remains from this set of pearls. Whatever money remains, again, feed it to the poor, feed it to the needy, feed it to the sadhus. The same process end. Now, the person who came to you was Brahma himself. So now, consider yourself as the wife of Brahma. Brahma is your husband. So do not sleep with another man and remain loyal to Brahma. Well, it was I think only a few weeks that the lives of both these people changed, because Brahma had to keep appearing every evening to this girl and offer her a beautiful set of pearls, which she would spend the next day, so nothing remains with her. Again, he had to appear the next day to offer her again a beautiful set of pearls, so that her destiny now can come true. A few weeks later, the disciple was contemplating the fate of his guru's children, that was how they have been able to change their life and hope that they're, you know, leading much better lives now. which they were, because the person who was a laborer or a porter, he was now the kind of the talk of the village. He was so much respected in the village because of all these lavish parties he was giving to the village every evening, and he was feeding all the sadhus. He was such a well-respected person. And this girl, who was earlier considered a prostitute, obviously no one saw anyone leave or enter her house any time, and she became a big philanthropist because she was spending all this money to all the good cause. She was feeding again the poor, the needy, the orphans, and the gurus and the sadhus. As he was contemplating what is the you know, how the change has happened in the lives of my guru's children, Brahma appeared before him and said, "What did you do? Now I have to go every day, first in the morning, to that boy's house to give him a sack of rice and a buffalo, and in the evening I have to go to that girl's house." He said, the disciple said, "Well, you can change their fate if you want. So if you want, you can change their destiny and change their fate. You don't have to do this if you don't want to do it." And then Brahma had no option, but he agreed to change their fate. And their fate did get changed. So this story actually teaches us many things, you know, including, of course, that we can, how we look at our fate or destiny is very important, and how we, you know, deal with it is crucial. We may have been dealt a hand, but how we deal with that hand, how do we make the best out of what has been given to us? And secondly, we need to really live in the moment and not worry so much about our future. If we believe in destiny, then it's going to happen what's going to happen, right? So let's live in the future, let's live life to the full. And the next moment, the destiny will provide to us if it is meant that it will be provided to us. And by doing good karmas in this life, which they did, in the sense, you know, they were feeding the poor and the hungry and the, you know, the sadhus, the destiny can be changed. Brahma did change their destinies. As a matter of fact, it reminds me of a Urdu couplet, poetry, you know, which my father would often recite to me when I was young. Ki khud ko kar buland itna ki khuda tujhse puche bata teri raza kya hai. You should make yourself so confident and so sure of yourself that it is God that who should come and ask you, what is that you want? What is that you desire? So, to answer your question, I think in a sentence, yes, we cannot sometimes change our faith or our destiny, but we can certainly live it differently. We can live it with a new perspective, and like they also say that, you know, if life gives you lemons, make a lemonade out of it. So if we live it with that attitude, then we will lead a good life, whatever the destiny has in store for us. Does not matter.